This is going to be more of a rambling, long-form brain dump. So, to give some context, I just got back from a trip from Manila with my best friends. And one of the ways I wanted to contribute was taking very nice B-roll video with the A7S III, which we're currently recording on. And the big event was like the yacht party, right? We rented a yacht, and I spent the whole day shooting, and out of like the 60 clips that I thought were usable, none were usable, absolutely zero. One was properly exposed, and the rest were just like overblown. And the one that was not overblown, the one that was properly exposed, it was like way too shaky. And I was watching this, I was like reviewing the clips on my flight back in horror. I was like, oh my God, how am I this incompetent with this camera? I could take pictures just fine, but I don't know how to shoot video with it. And just like, and the entire trip, the best footage that I took was all on the iPhone. Like my best clip was on the iPhone, a fraction of the cost of the A7S III, right? And that made me like just, it deeply, deeply, deeply bothered me. Part of it's because like my profession, whenever we make a mistake, no matter how small, we are encouraged to self-criticize, do root cause analysis, and do like a retrospective. We do that like every 2 weeks. So, damn, I just thought about this for such a long time, and I see where I made the mistakes, right? I could list them out, but at the end of the day, I just don't have that much experience shooting video with this model of camera. And things I'm still realizing now is I shot most of my video projects. I mean, I did like two meme projects were on the A7S II. Ever since I picked up this camera, as like, this isn't like my full-time job or anything, I actually haven't shot like an S-Log 3. So that's part of it. So that's like the first part I want to cover. The second part is, I've always stated that the iPhones, starting from iPhone 13, with enough light, it blows away any DSLR. It blows away the A7S III. This is currently a $4,000, $5,000 setup. An iPhone at $1,000, with enough light, it will outshoot it. It will produce better video with overall better workflow and everything. It shoots 4K, 4K HDR, and it does, it oversamples at like 6K and then stabilizes for you. And long story short, if the only reason to shoot with this camera, this nice cinema camera basically, is if you want like shallow depth of field, you want low light performance, and you want the benefits of S-Log 3. It's a special mode where you preserve more highlights and get wider dynamic range. My one sentence summary is, if you're not shooting an S-Log 3 with this camera, there's no reason why you should shoot with it. It's a waste of time, it's a waste of money. If you're not shooting S-Log 3, like people will tell you this, there's no reason for you to have this camera, right? So, I guess what I'm trying to say is, okay, so fast forward to today. I realized I don't have much experience shooting with this, and I was about to give up. I was so discouraged. I was about to just sell everything. But then I got with one of my good friends, Arthur, probably my best friend from Seattle. He is one of the most talented cinematographers, director of photography, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And he knows how my mind's like headspace gets. Once like one thing goes wrong, I just snowball and it just like spirals down. He's like, Chris, you're just way overthinking this. Here's my settings, just try it out. And I promise you that it is an easy workflow. So out of like this like sea of chaos, he was like this guiding light, just this hand, just take it, and he'll guide me. So with that said, I'm basically starting a, let's say, 14-day challenge, 30-day challenge. One of the things I learned from Atomic Habits was focus on starting. And another principle that I want to apply to this is starting with a beginner's mindset, like a childlike mind, right? I just want to pretend like I just got this camera just that delight of first getting this powerful camera and I want to actually make something with it, right? Just learn how to use it. And the idea is along the way, I'll uncover all my blind spots and most importantly, I'll make second nature all the little gotchas of this camera. Because to get this camera shooting right, from my perspective, there's like 20 little things that you need to make sure you have checked, right? Things from the picture profile, the zebra levels, the gamma assist on off, even the shutter speed, you have to like select it depending on your frame rate, your codec. You have to like figure out your codec. It's not that important, but there's a difference between intercompression and like speed compression and like one more, right? There's so many little things, right? And then there's the workflow of offloading this onto a computer. Offloading it to the computer and like editing it. All these things are like little friction points that seem pretty daunting to me. And if I forget any aspect of it, it just ruins everything. So I want to make all that autopilot, right? Because, well, yeah. And I guess so let's just state the challenge. For 14 days, I want to film with this camera and upload something every day. I also have to edit it myself, right? And I want to keep it as simple as possible. Like I've already kind of broken a rule by adding in like a single point lighting, but it was really quick to set up. So focus on the basics of recording, offloading, and editing and uploading, right? That's like the core backbone, right? And along the way, I want everything related to shooting SLR3. Okay, the ISO is 2500. That's another thing that you have to remember. When you're shooting SLR3, you need to make sure the ISO is above 640. That's another gotcha, right? It's really easy to set these settings when you're doing static shots like this. But the next complexity level is like dynamic shots where like the lighting's changing. At that point, you need a variable ND filter. All right, I want all that to be autopilot so that I don't think about any of that when I just bring out the camera. I want to get to a level where I could shoot with it like I do with my iPhone. And then another important gotcha was stabilization, right? When you're on a moving boat, the footage is shaky and you need to add in a 20% crop factor if you're going to stabilize. The iPhone already does that for you because it already samples with 6K. So what you see is actually already cropped in and stabilized. That was another like disconnect. So to reiterate, for 14 days, I'm going to be uploading things, just shooting things exclusively with this camera. And also like I could still use my phone, but primarily I want to shoot with this. I want to do basic editing to force myself to learn DaVinci Resolve. For today's video, I'm going to focus on editing-wise, color grading. SLR3 requires you to at least apply a translation LUT because right now it looks very flat to take advantage of that dynamic range. And audio, just like learning how to use the DJI mic correctly with this camera, saying the levels correctly and all that. So that's what I want to just nail down on autopilot. And along the way, my good friend Arthur will be helping me out and pointing out any like weaknesses in my like workflow, things that I'm very bad at getting stuck on something and just overthinking things. And as he says, psyching myself out. So yeah, that's all this video is. So day one, let's get this edited and uploaded. One more stipulation. I am not allowed to save and hold on to the raw files, the raw footage, long term. So after I'm done recording this, it's going to go into a temporary folder. I'll do my edits, I'll export it, and then I'll wipe that folder. Because I have gotten bogged down into archiving, asset management, all that, and it's not working for me, right? And the files get really huge. I just want to try that out and just try out that new workflow. Speaking of new workflows, another thing I want to learn to try out, zoom lenses. For those of you that know me, know that I try to like keep my lens collection to two glasses at most, primes. I freaking love primes. it's this arbitrary rule that I made for myself, and I don't know, I just want to learn to embrace Prime. I mean, learn to embrace Zooms, right? I want to have Arthur's approach of just use every tool, right? And learn to appreciate every tool. Arthur has like a very, very healthy mindset. I learned a lot from you, bud. Learn a lot from you, right? To not just like eschew a whole category of tools, right? So tomorrow I'll be getting the 1635 F4 coming in. I'm having gear acquisition syndrome. I know. But that'll be the only lens purchase with maybe the 24 1.4. We'll see about that. All right, that's all for today.